Hello, ladies and gentlemen. So, before you start flying, there is a lot of things that you need to take into account for you to make sure that you have everything according to your flight plan. So you need to take into account your flight plan, the weather forecast, threat and error management, mass and balance. So that there are a lot of steps that you need to look out before you get yourself into an airplane. And sometimes by being a few things, you might skip one another. So I'll show it to you how I do it, and I'll prepare a list of things to do. And if you follow all of those, your life will be easier, because the better the plan, the better the flight. So stay tuned, and don't worry, I'll leave on the description below all the websites for the different types of information. And thanks for the support, and I'll hit that like button and subscribe if you want to. Well, the first thing you need to take into account is where to. So where you will be departing and where you want to arrive. And if things go wrong, where are your alternates? At least one or two, or even more if you want to. Well, the second part, and it's when things start to get interesting, it's the weather. So on the weather, there are at least three types of charts that you need to take into account, which is wind and temperature charts, surface pressure charts, and significant weather charts. I'll be talking about each one of those for you to have more or less an idea of what do you have to look out for. So, starting with wind and temperature charts. Wind and temperature charts, it's a map of a region of the world that shows in a general view the forecast of the direction and intensity of the wind and the temperature in a given altitude. So for example, you have to take into account the wind and the wind direction and the temperature of your departing aerodrome, of the alternates, and of your arrival aerodrome. And not only that, but you need to take into account the wind direction for your flight plan route, because if you don't take into account, you will probably drift from your flight plan. Well, the second chart that you need to look out are surface pressure charts. So basically, they show the surface pressure pattern using the isobars, which are lines of equal pressure, and they indicate areas of high and low pressure along their center pressure value. All of this in a synoptic scale, of course. So basically, you need to have a look which type of front that it's approaching. If it's a cold front, if it's a warm front, if it's an occluded, if it's a front that it's growing, if a front that it's dying. And not only that, as you can always see the isobars, and the closer they are, it means that the wind speed will be faster. So take into account that type of approach while you are seeing the chart. Well, the last chart that I look out for, it's the significant weather chart. So basically, the significant weather chart, it will show you the height of the tropopause, it will show you where are clear air turbulence, jet streams, CBs, which stands for cumulonimbus, which are clouds with a huge vertical development. So usually when you see a CB, you know that probably there are thunderstorms and rain inside, and you always try to avoid those type of clouds, especially if you are on a single engine. Well, now the weather is checked, and now we'll start to look out for the aircraft documents. I personally found out a mnemonic, which it's called Aero, which stands for the airworthiness of the aircraft, the radio of the aircraft, if everything is okay, the radio license, the registration license, the operating of the aircraft, and the mass and balance, the weight. So those are at least the five main documents that you need to take into account. Well, not talking about the noise abatement if in some cases, and the insurance in all of those. So at least all of these documents you need to have a look if the aircraft has it, and if everything it's according to the legality of it. So you've already seen the weather, you've already had a look on the aircraft documents, so it's time for you to prepare your navigation. And it's for example, if you want to go from Alpha to Bravo and you having and wind coming from the left side, you know that you'll be drifting to the right. So you, in order to follow the track that you want, you need to correct to the heading, so in order not to drift. So this type of information and calculations, it's here that you start to do. You will have a look on the variation of the charts, on the magnetic variations. You have to see because of that what it will be your true heading or your magnetic heading, such as your true track, your magnetic track. So how long you will take from one point to another, and by knowing that and with the fuel calculations that you have a prediction how much fuel you'll be spending throughout that leg, and these are the where you start to sum all the important details in order for you to have the smoothest flight as possible. So now it's time for you to grab the POH and or the AFM of your aircraft in order for you to see the weight of the aircraft. So because now it's the time for the mass and balance. So it's here where you will calculate the center of gravity of your aircraft, where you will see if you are within the envelope limits. If the weight of the aircraft and plus your calculations, if it's below the maximum takeoff mass and if it's below as well of the maximum landing mass. So it's here that you'll see if everything it's according, it's within the limits basically. This is an example of a Piper mass and balance sheet. So as you can see, all the calculations have been made, and here there is a graph of the CG, so it's in within the limits. Well, you can see the takeoff mass, the zero fuel mass, the landing mass, and the alternate as well. We've already forecast the weather, we've already calculated the mass and balance, we've already did our navigation log. So now it's time for us to see if we are able to take off or not. So it's now it's the performance department. It's basically where you'll see that according to all of the temperature, the weight, if everything it's going within the limits in order for you to perform a takeoff without using all the runway available. And not only on the takeoff, but on the landing and on the alternate as well. So it's on this paper that you will put the takeoff mass, the center of gravity, the elevations, the wind velocity at the time that you'll be taking off. And as you can see, on the takeoff distance required, you will see and you will compare if the one that you will require, it's below the limits of the takeoff runway available or the accelerate and stop distance available. And as well on the landing performance, if the landing distance required, it's below the landing distance available of the aerodrome that you will be landing. Well, last but not least, it's time for you to check the NOTAMs. So NOTAMs basically are informations regarding to the facilities or establishments of the aerodrome. So for example, if you have a runway that it's inoperative, there will be a NOTAM that will be emitted saying that the runway itself, it's inoperative during a certain amount of time. So you need to take that into account because you might calculate for landing or takeoff on that runway that it's inoperative. So have a look in every single flight, all the NOTAMs regarding to the places that you'll be taking off and that you will be arriving as well. Now, you need to fulfill a flight plan sheet in order for you to send to the appropriate authorities to be accepted to perform the flight without having any problems regarding to the authorities. So on this sheet, you will put your call sign, your equipment, so what type of flight it is, your route, altitudes, and all the specific details for them to know who you are, where you are, and what you're going to do. So now, for the last part, we'll be talking about threat and error management and how to mitigate them. For example, if you are in an aerodrome that there are more than one flying school, or you're in an aerodrome that there is a lot of traffic and you don't have TCAS, for example, you need to look out and listen out as always, but that's one of threat and error management, and looking out and listen out, it's how do you mitigate them. If it's an instruction flight, it's a threat and error management. So how to mitigate them? Studying the SOPs, being prepared. So there are a lot of factors that you need to take into account. So the weather, for example, it's another threat and error management. How to mitigate them? Make a very good calculations and try to be as precise as possible. So basically, there are several factors that you need to take into account: runways in use, the winds, and all that. It's here on the threat and error management that you will talk about it. This it's how I plan my flights. It's not a strictly basis that you will have to do it as well. This is how I do it, and I've never had an issue when it comes to the briefings, because if you follow the same steps as you're following this ones, and the only add it's when it comes to the NOTAMs, you'll be talking as well of the METARs and the TAFs. Besides that, the plan that you'll be making, it will be the same as the briefing that you'll be giving. So if you follow these steps, I believe that even if you're flying solo, if you do it every single flight for you, because you are the captain, you are the pilot in command, and you have the responsibility to try to be as precise as possible in every single flight. So I hope you like it, guys. I hope you've learned with this video. Oh, and don't worry, on the description below, I will leave the websites regarding all of the information that you can find out, such as the NOTAMs, surface pressure charts, and so on. So I hope you like it, guys. Please hit that like button and subscribe if you want to see more.